My name is Alan Howe. I'm a board member for the Art in Public Places program. Since the program started in 1995, there's been a little over 60 installations throughout the city. The real job of the board is to make sure that the art be appropriate for the site. It's a challenge. Art is fairly subjective, and we really look for the best possible solution. A good example of this is the East Prospect entryway. This is considered a natural area, and the art that is over there reflects what really goes on in the area. So we felt like this was very appropriate. Another recently completed project is Andy Dufford's work at the new police facility.
What we wanted was to use the art to create beauty and comfort. When people come to the police facility, usually they're under stress, and the art can help minimize that stress and create a calming influence. The Memorial Garden has a special relationship to the rest of the building. It's a nice place where people can pull out of that main current of activity and enjoy the beauty of the plantings, the sound of the fountains, and it's a great place just to sit and hang out. The Memorial Garden finishes inside here at the interior fountain, and its purpose is not only to look beautiful, but to sound beautiful.
Light and Power came to us and said, we're spending a lot of money trying to get rid of graffiti on these transformers.
I had seen these boxes around town and I'd heard about the project, and I said, you know, these would probably look best as flower boxes. This technique of using mosaic pointillism puts the R in arduous. If it wasn't for the fact that the effect was so amazing, I wouldn't still be doing it. When I first got this account, I said, oh my goodness gracious, there was a dumpster out here. It was like an oil catcher for the Chinese restaurant. I felt like I'd kind of gotten shorted on the location. And this has turned out to be the most fascinating alley. People come up to me and they'll be bringing me soda pop and water and very, very friendly. And that really gave me a lot of knowledge about the city of Fort Collins, about the diversity of people that live here. I get to talk to the taggers and meet with them. I'm serious. I've talked with people who tag things in the city, and they just love this stuff. I think that these pieces are going to be protected by their mere beauty. I think people who tag also have an art appreciation.
Hi, my name is Michael Shalona. I'm the chair of the Parks and Recs Board. One of the big items we're tackling this year is the update or redo of the 1996 plan. There's some new thoughts out there on how you can place parks, look at population growth. The city's changed since 1996. To really see what the thoughts are with the general public and how all that can get really incorporated back into this new policy plan. We can't wait for it, the new Northside Community Center that's coming online. The new facility is nearly three times the size, 50,000 square feet. It offers lots more basketball courts, indoor walking, running tracks, a lot of other great amenities that weren't there before, and it's going to really help service that north side of Fort Collins and the downtown area.
One, two, three!
We're extremely excited about the opening of Spring Canyon Park. Its location is really awesome next to the foothills. It really brings in the beauty of Colorado and why we live on the Front Range. You're still real tied into the community and the neighborhood surrounding it. There's great trails for pedestrians, for people on bikes, horses, great ball fields. It allows you to do nearly a 1.5 mile loop without ever crossing any roads. You can go right underneath the entrance bridge, a mountain bike park that allows people of different levels to be able to get out there. It's going to offer a lot for everybody. Spring Canyon Community Park also has some great art in public places.
They just said, well, we need somebody who loves nature and who also can do something that works with the restroom. This mural is called Nature's Calling. People are just going to come in here, and for a split second, they're going to forget even why they're in here.
Some of the trees that had to come down, but we left the stumps. We have one artist that's in there, and he's carving really unique chainsaw art and sculpture. Inspiration Playground is going to be awesome. It's probably, if not the biggest accessible playground in the state of Colorado. It's probably really close to it.
Commission on Disability makes recommendations to City Council regarding Americans with Disabilities Act issues that we have in our community. For example, parks like today, getting around town. Every year, the Commission on Disability has a Mayor's Award, and we awarded Brownie McGraw the Spirit of Fort Collins for this playground.
I was very honored to accept this award from the Disabilities Commission, but I accepted it for our 28 volunteer Inspiration Playground Committee who did this work. It was many other people who worked hard for 4.5 years to raise the money for this because it was a passion. When you look here and see what is happening, people in cars or vans, getting their children out, putting them in wheelchairs, and other children were coming up and saying, come play with me. That's the whole purpose of this.
And one of the other great things is this very unique giant that's kind of laying down under the earth. You can see part of his head and in the field. You can see his toes sticking up. I personally can't wait to go climb up on the giant and rub my hand in his nostril to feel that nose hair in there.
The Affordable Housing Board's job is to advise the City Council on any matters related to affordable housing in the City of Fort Collins. In terms of funding, we work with the CDBG Commission. The Affordable Housing Board reviews all the affordable housing proposals that are submitted to the City. We rank those proposals that are related to affordable housing, and we forward our ranking to the CDBG Commission. They're the ones that make the final recommendation to City Council. One of the proposals that came before the boards was this proposal for this development from Habitat for Humanity.
We've been in our Habitat for Humanity home for 6 months. It's a beautiful home, and we're really happy to be here and to be in this neighborhood. Being in an apartment, people came and left, and we never really made any connections. Owning our own home has given me a sense of stability and having roots in a community now.
Back when we were in our apartment, we didn't have as much. We have 3 floors.
We are looking for one more person because the other person quit.
Well, that sounds good. I'll go get my money. I'll be right back.
What's your favorite room?
My favorite room is my room.
Shh, Teach must be nearby. We have to get out of here before it's too late.
It has a jungle. And I feel welcome and comfortable in there.
Of course, we got the Rockies hat today.
What is it?
I still have those stressful days, but I have that peace that I'm here, I get to stay.
I think all the people that serve on the boards in Fort Collins have something in common. They see a chance to not only give of themselves, but to make Fort Collins a better place to live.
I grew up that my sister or my parents had to get me on the slide or the swings. It's nice that there'll be disabled children who will now have the opportunity that I didn't get.
I've really enjoyed being on the board, being able to help see Fort Collins park system and recreation system grow and prosper.
One of the first things that I did when we moved to town 6 years ago was to go on the city website and look for an opportunity to get involved in the community. And that's how I've learned about the Affordable Housing Board.
We're here because of so many different people. Hopefully they know what a great home that they have helped us build to live in and to grow in.